The State Perg started Green Corps in 1992 to train environmental organizers. Earth Day 1990 had just happened. There was a huge upsurge in interest in environmental issues. Most of the actions around Earth Day 1990 focused on just individual actions and personal choices. So Green Corps was founded to help people take the step beyond making personal changes in their life and really to organize people in a concerted way to build a constituency and to advocate for political change.
Well, you know, I was at the very early conversations when a number of environmental leaders said we need more young people who have been trained to have the skills to be effective advocates and effective organizers.
When I graduated from college, I was interested in environmental work. I'd done some environmental activism in college. And I was interested in how to make that into a career, but they don't tell you in college how to be an environmentalist. Green Corps was a way that I could get out there and really make a difference on environmental issues, learn a lot of skills really quickly, and get a lot of different kind of experience in the first year. One of the most valuable things I got out of Green Corps was the tremendously valuable training that we got. First, the classroom training with some of these legends in environmental work. David Brower, who's just a hero of the environmental movement. Lois Gibbs from Love Canal, who had shown such personal strength and organizing skill in her fight. And then we had the practical training, going out and actually running the campaigns. You're out there in your own city doing your own thing, running these campaigns, and really as the person who is bottom line responsible for making it happen. My experience with Green Corps really gave me both the skills and the confidence to be able to go on to a career as an organizer. I'm working now with MoveOn.org, which is the progressive online organization. And my role has been to turn it from just the progressive online organization to the progressive online and in your neighborhood organization. After the 2004 election, we'd engaged about 75,000 volunteers, and then we wanted to keep that network going. So we created this field network called Operation Democracy. What Operation Democracy does is provides leadership and infrastructure for the rest of MoveOn's 3 million members around the country. This is kind of Green Corps 101 right here, the idea that as an organizer, you're trying to amplify your effect, not just do the work yourself, but that's the power of grassroots organizing.
I grew up in a small town in Northern California called Sonoma Valley. When I was in eighth grade, I went to Yosemite for the first time and went hiking and sort of experienced the Sierra Nevada for the first time, and I just absolutely fell in love and sort of learned everything that I could about the Sierra Nevada and the history, and realized that there was this whole movement that had been formed 100 years prior, roughly, to protect it and preserve it. So I started, you know, gobbling up everything I could read about this John Muir and the Sierra Club, and just got really into sort of this notion of people working together and organizing to protect these places that I had grown to love so much. When I discovered Green Corps, I thought, this is, you know, match made in heaven. It's a perfect program. The responsibilities were huge, which was so refreshing. But my job was to basically set up shop in Connecticut, open up with one colleague, open up a new office for the Toxics Action Center, and to launch for the first time a statewide campaign to clean up the old coal and oil burning power plants in the state. Because I was having such a good experience, I ended up staying on in Connecticut with the Toxics Action Center after my year at Green Corps, and continuing to sort of work with Toxics Action Center staff to see that campaign through. Now I've come back to my home state of California, and I'm the clean energy advocate for Environment California, which is a statewide nonprofit environmental organization. My focus right now is promoting solar power. We just passed SB1, the Million Solar Roofs Initiative, a bill I sponsored and wrote. With that campaign did was basically set out as a statewide goal, California, to build 1 million solar roofs, solar electric roofs, over the next 10 years. It took us a long time. We had a lot of opposition. It took us 4 years. You know, ultimately, if we're going to solve these daunting environmental problems, we're going to have to do it with the support of the public, and we're going to have to organize people power in order to go up against special interests. You know, that basic concept of organizing is exactly what Green Corps taught me.
Green Corps' greatest accomplishment has really been building up a community of skilled, committed, and strategic organizers across the social change movement. We've graduated more than 275 folks through our program, and they're all over the place. Whether they're working to take on some of the largest corporations in the world with groups like Rainforest Action Network or Corporate Accountability International, or working to protect local communities with groups like Gulf Restoration Network and Heal Utah. I'm so proud of the Green Corps alumni that are out there every day working with communities, building up the long-term power we need to make social change happen.
As a movement, we have plenty of really terrific lawyers and lobbyists and scientists and issue experts. What we really lack is talented, skilled, professional organizers.
The work that I was doing with this local community group, I felt like I was actually able to, even though I was just out of school, pass on some of the things that I had learned in my Green Corps training to these local community organizers so they could continue doing even more effective work.
After school, I was lucky enough to work for Green Corps. That 1 year packed in so much comprehensive experience that I came out with training in how to do media work, how to build coalitions, how to manage staff, how to be a leader and a manager, and how to do campaign planning, and it just gave me the foundation for my career now.
We know that the public is on our side on solving problems like global warming. The challenge is to translate that public support into public action. And that's exactly what Green Corps does.
My experience working with Green Corps alum has just been terrific. They have a great work ethic. They understand organizing. They're very smart strategically.
You know, there could not be a better model than the Green Corps model. And it's been great fun to be a little part of it over the years.
We had camera crews from two different TV stations there, and it was really a tremendous event. And I just remember as I was doing it thinking, I can't believe it works just like they said it would. It's just like in Green Corps training, just like we role played, it really works.
What, you know, honestly keeps me motivated, keeps me doing this is you have, you know, these very narrow special interests fighting you every step of the way. Yet through organizing and through kind of galvanizing all that public opinion and public support, you can overcome those special interests and win. That's really fun. And it's really motivating. It just frankly, it's I think ultimately what keeps me doing this year after year.